Nothing kills snack time quite like staleness. Your palate deserves better than that bland, bendy tortilla chip or that crusty, brittle bread, so we've worked out the chemical basics of staling just for you. All the better to give you some pro tips to maximize your snacking potential just in time for football season. Both bread and chips get stale, but why is it that bread gets harder while chips get softer? The answer has a lot to do with moisture, but not moisture exclusively. The whole process of staling hasn't been completely figured out by scientists at this point, but major factors have been identified. First, let's take a quick look at bread. Inside the loaf of bread, you're going to find webs of wheat flour protein, or gluten, and also starch molecules. These webs create scaffolding around tiny carbon dioxide air pockets that are created by yeast when they munch down on sugars in the bread while it rises. This structure is what makes bread inherently spongy. It also helps keep moisture in. The starches in bread are made up of two primary units, amylose and amylopectin. When bread is baked, the amylose molecules break down and lose their moisture within the first day of the loaf's life. You can tell they're still in good shape when the bread is really fresh out of the oven and easily sliced. The amylopectin, on the other hand, form crystalline structures that keep moisture trapped in place much longer. It's a slow breakdown of these molecules that inevitably let moisture out of the bread, giving it that hard, crumbly texture. Now as for those chips, it's all about moisture. Chips lose nearly all of their moisture when they're flash fried, which evaporates off thanks to the high heat of the oil. Both chips and bread contain a lot of starch molecules, which are hydrophilic by nature. That is, they absorb water. Perfectly dried out chips make these starches pretty thirsty, so they grab water molecules from the air around them. This water then softens the chips, making them lose their addictive crunch. This process also happens to bread when hydrophilic starches in the crust suck moisture from the interior of the loaf, leaving it dried out and stale. So if air softens chips, why don't they come out of the bag soft already? I mean, look at this bag, it's like a balloon. One study suggested that some chip bags contain upwards of 86% air inside, inviting sustainable critique, because that's a lot of thin air being delivered all over the world. But get this, folks, chip bag engineers are ahead of the staleness curve. Those bags aren't filled with just plain old air, they're filled with nitrogen gas. Nitrogen is an inert gas, which means it's less reactive than other gases in the air. Also, when the bags are inflated, there's no moisture included in the mix, making your chips stay nice and crispy inside. And for the record here, folks, the reason chip bags are so inflated is to keep the chips from being crushed when in transit. Okay, so now that we've got the basics down, what's the best way to keep your loaf nice and fresh? Pro tip, temperature is key. Bread stored in the refrigerator will go stale up to 6 times faster than bread kept at room temperature. On the other hand, a loaf that's well sealed in foil or plastic and put in the freezer will keep the longest. If you plan to eat your loaf in 1 or 2 days, using a bread box or paper bag does the best job at maintaining moisture. But don't use plastic bags because they end up trapping in expelled moisture from the staling process. That can lead to moisture buildup and blue-green mold growth. Now how about salvaging your stale bread and chips? You wouldn't believe how easy it actually is. For chips, throw them into the microwave on high for 30 seconds and nearly all that moisture will leave, giving you a seemingly brand new batch. As for your bread, a newly staled loaf can be tossed in the oven at 60 degrees Celsius and reheated to help it suck up more moisture. Alright folks, we just gave you some snack food pro tips, now we want to hear yours. Post your favorite snack time related life hack in the comments and we'll tweet out our favorites. If you want something special to eat your chips with, check out this video on how to make the perfect nacho cheese. Also, check out this chemistry life hacks video to see how to make hard cookies go soft. Don't forget to post your chemistry related questions in the comments. Thanks for watching folks, don't forget to subscribe, hit thumbs up on the way out.